giving us much. Are you going to give us halfway through? Are you going to give us...
I'll start standing up and elbowing you like I did with these guys.
All right, so yesterday we started with an idea of what can we do to spark a conversation between two strangers. There was a couple of different ways we could have done that. Maybe it was technology, maybe it was something a little bit more physical, less technology. We bounced some ideas and came up with, an idea.
Yeah.
So it was something to just help spark conversations. And we thought, well, why not just start with a sign? We actually also went out today and had a conversation with a few people, passerbyers like you and me, and we also had a chat with a nice fella.
Homeless guy with a dog who had sunglasses on.
Yeah.
And he used the dog as a way of talking to people, basically. People, his point was, his anecdote was that people just ignore him and they pay attention to the dog, and that's what draws people in, the fact that the dog's got sunglasses on, that's great. And he has a sign that says, my name's Jeffrey or something, you can take pictures of me, that's fine. And that's the way that he engages with people, he uses that prop to do that. And this stems back from, you know, the last couple of days we've been talking about various different ideas of maybe signage or poster campaigns or different
or
things.
Friendly like bench.
Friendly bench. And we sort of finally went out and sort of prototyped this stuff this morning. We spoke to, as you say, the homeless person who gave us some insight as to what things he likes to talk about and what he doesn't like to talk about. So he's not necessarily keen on talking about his past. He said he didn't particularly want to talk about his marriage, but he also didn't want to talk about his life generally. And I think that his marriage is particularly a pain point, but his life generally, I think, was something he didn't want to talk about because it's something he's spoken to so many people about and given that story so many times. And just to talk to people on the street and being asked the same question constantly is just not something he wanted to do. What he did want to do, though, was talk to us about art. He really wanted to talk about modern art, which is not the thing that you would expect. But actually, this is something that we knew a lot of people that I know have in common, and actually if that's something that we can have in common with homeless people, then that's a great thing that kind of builds up some kind of commonalities and empathy with people, which I think is a really key point in not just talking to people, but kind of the start of a conversation and then seeing where that conversation goes. It's sort of serendipity, if you like. So
we came back here,
yeah.
And we said, okay, let's do something now. We've got some information on hand. Let's actually build a sign. So I came up with something that looks a bit like this. And because I thought, well, okay, it's big, it's clear, it's asking for something that he can change. So if he wants a smoke for the day at that moment, or if he wants some food, then he can swap out the signs and be a little bit more descriptive about what he needs.
The text from the...
Oh yeah, do you want to step to that way?
Pull the plug.
Like,
where do you want me to go?
Yeah.
Oh, there we go.
Okay.
So yeah, so stuff like that. Or this. You know, what might he need that day? So we thought, okay, well, let's go test this out and see what happens. So we went out, tested it, gave it to a guy, and he doesn't speak English very well, so we said, all right, well, let's draw a picture of a cigarette instead. And he was happy to hold it up. We went to another fellow and said, hey, we're doing a bit of a thing today. Would you be willing to hold up a sign? And he's like, oh, I'd love to, but it's against the law. And we're like, what? How is that against the law? Isn't that against freedom of speech? It's if I, you know, that sort of thing. So we said, okay, well, we got to get back and find out if this is real or not. Came back, and luckily we had a lawyer on hand that we could ask about that. And she basically said, yeah, because there's this thing called the Vagrancy Act, which is if you're asking for something, it's not all right. So, in conclusion, this sign is not okay, but this one is okay. And this is what can basically spark conversations. So what we'd like to do is basically put this on a little Trello board finding, we'll call it Stranger No More, but we'd like to kind of document what we've done, the research we found, and what works in terms of putting a sign together so that it empowers both a homeless person and a passerby. So what I didn't manage to put on here was maybe a link to a URL where if I'm passing by and I can capture that URL, I can go on there and find out how I can make a sign for another person and give it to that other person, or find resources or that sort of thing. So
I think this is, you know, in terms of where this comes in and how it's useful in terms of need, obviously we're still at the research stage, we're still trying to work out, you know, what the channels are of trying to communicate stuff. Sign is one way of doing that. There's probably other ways of doing it as well. But if this is an official campaign, we can't say, I don't think, can you go and give people cigarettes? Can you donate stuff? We can say, start talking to homeless people, start a conversation, which is probably our main point, really,
yeah.
Isn't it?
Yeah, so they can't ask for stuff, but we can go talk to them about something. We can ask for a conversation.